Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. And welcome back to another episode of When Beauty Turns Ugly. I'm glad you're enjoying this series. I say series, there's only 2 episodes as of this video, but there's more coming soon, I promise. Before we get into the video, for legal reasons, of course everything I talk about in today's video is purely for entertainment. I'm not a good researcher. I don't know legal stuff, so it's all for entertainment. So everything is of course alleged and in my opinion only for legal reasons. So today's brand, I'm not a huge fan of, I must be honest. And it's not because they've done anything wrong. Well, we'll talk about that. As you know though, I'm not a fan of the clean, natural skincare kind of movement. To me, it's very anti-science. It kind of diminishes all the work that amazing cosmetic chemists and researchers have put into creating some amazing skincare products that can really benefit you. And it's kind of anti-science in the way that it doesn't quite explain how irritating and allergenic a lot of natural ingredients can be, and how the lack of preservatives in skincare can cause such huge issues as well. Anyway, the brand in question today is YesTo, an American natural skincare brand only founded in 2006. So really it's kind of new still. Well, wait. Yeah. By two friends who wanted to create a super all-natural skincare line with proven results that was affordable, free from all nasties. This is where the fear to sell comes in. And all their collections are kind of built around one specific fruit or vegetable, and there's even a charcoal range as well. And before we get into the lawsuit today, spoiler, there's going to be a lawsuit, I just want to touch on one section of their website. I do a lot of videos about filters online, false advertising, Instagram versus reality stuff, and on their website that I'm looking at now, they have a why we fight section and what they supposedly stand for. And on this section, they say, life is serious enough without everyday pressures of work, university, relationships, money, body shape, and everything in between. Socials are great for staying in touch and sharing our lives, but the fact is, we all know it's not real. It's filtered, photoshopped, and carefully managed. They're saying that they're campaigning for everyone to take a step back and celebrate their individuality. Yes, to promote being yourself and loving the skin you're in. Which is great. However, if we take a look at their social media, which is one thing they talk about here, and their website, I wouldn't say, even looking at their packaging, that their brand is very inclusive or diverse, really. I mean, there's a lot more to inclusivity and diversity than skin color and skin tone, which is a huge factor and hugely important when it comes to embracing everyone and being inclusive. But there's also body size, face shape, condition of your skin. Their social media, which I'm looking at now, is just models and influencers, so I wouldn't really say they're everyday people. And whilst this isn't something that I'd usually nitpick on, the fact that they have a whole section on their website talking about this, whilst really their packaging just shows the same woman with a different skin tone, it's showboating, it's gimmicky, it's another reason I don't like this brand. Anyway, enough about my opinions. To be fair to YesTo, they have very affordable price points, their products are fine, they're easily accessible, cruelty-free, and they're also hugely popular. In fact, some of their masks actually outsell L'Oreal's best-selling masks, and they're always nominated for beauty awards as well. I'm not sure how many they've won, but a nomination is still a good thing, right? However, one of their most popular products went viral for all the wrong reasons. So whilst we talk about this, I'm going to be doing a skin brightening skincare routine. We're talking about evening out skin tone, getting rid of dull skin. So I've already cleansed my face with the MURAD Environmental Shield Essential C Cleanser. I think when my skin's a bit sensitive, I like to use actives in a face wash. So I'm going to rehydrate and apply a serum. This is Jordan Samuel Skin Hydrate the Mist. Ooh. So let's go back to late December of 2019, kind of early January 2020. I couldn't find an exact date, I'm sorry. But Alicia from Apex, North Carolina, is shopping with her 5-year-old daughter, and they fancied a bit of a spa day, you know, a bit of girl time. She says her daughter is a girly girl who likes bath times, pampering herself, she gets her nails done. So she thought it'd be cute to have a bit of fun spa day. I think that's cute, I think that's sweet. So when it came to picking out the products for their spa day, her 5-year-old daughter was naturally drawn to this shiny holographic pinky unicorn covered sheet mask packaging. The sheet mask was the YesTo Grapefruit Vitamin C Glow Boosting Unicorn Sheet Mask. No, paper mask. I mean, look at it. What child wouldn't want this mask? It's pink, it's glittery, it's holographic, it's cute, you know, it's really, really attractive. Even I'm tempted looking at this, and I know what this is gonna do to her face. You know, despite the outdated vector drawings, which are really popular in the 2000s, As the name suggests, this is a brightening mask that actually uses citrus extracts, aka grapefruit, along with lactic acid to help brighten and even out skin tone. I'm guessing they're saying grapefruit is part of the vitamin C. I mean, this is the thing with this brand. They need a fruit to have a gimmick, right, and be able to sell. Lactic acid is an AHA that can help exfoliate and can help brighten and even out your skin tone. But we also have tetrahexadecyl ascorbate, a vitamin C derivative, which I believe is more stable than most vitamin C derivatives, a nice antioxidant and skin brightener. Talking of skin brightening, we're gonna go with the Galactomyces and Niacinamide Serum. Niacinamide, again, is known to help even out skin tone. And Galactomyces are really nicely moisturizing. They also have this like anti-aging property to them as well. So Alicia and her daughter, they got home from their shopping trip ready for their mini spa day. And they whip out this glittery pink sheet mask, which in my opinion is clearly targeted to a younger audience. So her 5-year-old daughter has this paper sheet mask on her face. So the brand actually recommend you leave this mask on for 10 minutes. However, after only 5 minutes of this 5-year-old girl, I keep stressing she's only 5 years old, using this glittery hot pink paper sheet mask, they start to notice that something really isn't right. Alicia's poor daughter started to cry, complaining that the mask was burning her face, saying that her face hurt, so they took off the mask immediately and her face was red, swollen, itchy, and it was so irritated that it was hot to touch. Her daughter had clearly had a very, very bad reaction to this product. And in the previous video, we talked about bad reactions to product. It happens, right? So of course, Alicia sprang into action and went to soothe her daughter's skin. I think she used like some aloe gel. Alicia double checked over the packaging just to make sure that there wasn't anything that she was doing wrong. However, this wasn't just a one-off case. So if you're like me and you're a grown adult and for some reason you're still attracted to bright things, sparkly things, cute stuff, anything that basically comes with a gimmick, you might have given this a go yourself as an adult. And I do feel like pampering yourself in skincare takes on a whole new meaning when you're an adult. You know, those 5 minutes that you can get, if that, just to have some you time to look after yourself means so much. So I guess like when Kayla Pagus, I guess I'm saying that last name wrong, I'm so sorry, also gave this mask a go around the same time, around December, late December, January, she was hoping for a nice chilled evening and some brighter, glowier skin. Not flaming hot, red, bumpy skin. Just like Alicia's daughter, after wearing the mask for only 3 minutes, Kayla's face started to get extremely hot. So of course she removed the mask. I was in shock when she saw how her skin reacted to this product. Now, she isn't a 5-year-old girl, so she's used actives on her skin before. Her skin can quite well tolerate these kind of ingredients. But to see a sheet mask leave her skin this red, hot, itchy, and irritated, it had her in shock. And her skin was hot and red for days. Not just hours, but days. However, one of the worst cases I've seen from this case was that of Lauren Moore from Kansas City. Similar situation, bought this sheet mask in a store just for fun. And in fact, when asked why she bought this mask, she says she bought it because of the shiny packaging and like how kiddish it sort of looked. So she thought it might be fun to try on. Now here's where it gets kind of annoying, because unlike everyone else, and not their fault, because you shouldn't have to do this, but before buying the mask and before using it, she actually checked the packaging for warnings and instructions. And she actually noted that on the back of this packaging, the brand says if it's tingling, it's working. Now, that is usually a red flag. There are definitely some products that are going to give you a slight tingling sensation, usually high percentage exfoliants, high percentage actives, products that are usually geared towards an older, more experienced audience when it comes to skincare, not unicorn holographic sheet masks that, whilst not necessary for kids, is in kiddish packaging, right? So other than what I mentioned, if a product's tingling your skin, it's usually a bad sign. So to instruct that if it's tingling and stinging your face, essentially, because a lot of people can't really tell the difference. I know I can't. Hi, Bishop. If it's hurting your face, it's working, they're basically saying, so keep on for as long as you can. But again, Lauren only lasted 3 minutes with this on her face before she had to take it off because of the burning, the itching, and the fact that the burning was actually making her eyes water. Lauren went on to tell WDAF-TV that it makes me feel like I should probably check the label before using face masks or stuff like that, because there are really harmful chemicals that could be in the mask that I hadn't experienced before. When in my opinion, this probably doesn't have a lot to do with the actual man-made synthetic ingredients, but the more naturally derived ingredients in this product. So Lauren Moore and her mother actually posted pictures of before and after of what happened to Lauren's face. And just like the EOS case, hundreds and hundreds of people replied and commented on the picture, saying that they had just exactly the same experience. Forcing YesTo to make a statement. If you want a brand to make a statement, post your pictures on Facebook. YesTo say that in light of reports that our grapefruit vitamin C glow-boosting unicorn paper mask, the longest name, has resulted in skin irritation for some consumers, there was literally hundreds of replies, YesTo has decided to remove this particular product from the store shelves whilst we investigate. At YesTo, the safety and satisfaction of our customers are our main concerns. We value you and apologize to anyone who was affected in this way, especially over the holiday season. Over Thanksgiving and Christmas, people were using these masks, having this reaction and complaining. But great, right? YesTo have listened to this feedback and pulled all their products, all their sheet masks off the shelves. So hopefully no one else is going to experience this kind of reaction. But there's a bit of an issue here. YesTo have been a little bit naughty. Allegedly, and only in my opinion, YesTo knew about this issue way before the end of December. They knew from customer complaints and feedback and product reviews on their own website that people had been experiencing these reactions way before Lauren Moore's Facebook post, but did nothing about it. And kind of just swept under the rug. More of that in a bit. So let's look at the actual lawsuit itself. The lawsuit is actually from someone who we haven't heard of before, who hasn't publicly posted about their reactions. That person being Imani Whitefield, and on behalf of basically everyone who claims to have had a reaction from the unicorn paper mask. The lawyers are Bursa and Fisher, and have won some very high profile cases against some very high profile companies like Condé Nast, Verizon, and LG. I mean, there's not a lot to prove here, right? They use the mask. You can see in the reaction pictures the physical outline of the sheet mask where I'm not laughing. I laugh when I'm nervous or annoyed. But you can see the line on this poor 5-year-old girl's face. You can see exactly where the sheet mask was. According to the official lawsuit brought to YesTo, complaints about this mask were brought to the company's attention as early as September of 2019. Whilst a flood of complaints hit their online store around the end of December, these complaints were all posted on the same day. I do not think this means that they were fake complaints kind of made by one person, all posted in the same day. I know that a lot of websites and that I've personally worked for have a kind of approval process or scanning for spam where someone will physically go through the feedback and make sure it's not spammy or rude or anything like that, and then bulk approve them and they'll hit the website. So the lawsuit goes on to state that indeed there are social media reports of consumers reporting the issue to the defendant as early as September of 2019, months before the recall. The defendant being YesTo knew about this post because the defendant actually responded to a Facebook comment and, instead of making customers aware and initiating a recall, swept it under the rug and instructed the user to email YesTo customer service team. Vitamin C is a great skin brightening ingredient. When it comes to sheet masks, I don't really think the benefits are all there. It's best off using a serum because you kind of have to use one of these every day for at least a month before you start seeing the benefits. What these are great for is immediate hydration and immediate dewy look. This to me seems to be the repackaged version without the unicorn and all the fun stuff on it. So let's give it a go. They go on to say in the lawsuit that, however, despite, oh look, it's not pink anymore. No. Oh, that smells like, sick. That smells like really acidy sick. However, they go on to say, despite the knowledge of the defect, defendant failed to act to remediate the issue and thereby affirmatively misrepresenting and or omitting facts regarding dangers of the unicorn mask. So here we go. We have the like holes. Weird. Why are they like that? Why are they shaped like that? I guess it's just to make sure that it gets nowhere near the eyes. They go on to basically say that the delay meant that YesTo can reap the benefits of the faulty sheet mask. The financial benefits, I should say. What is going on? Because of my beard, I just tend to flick it up like this. And this was even more frustrating because it seemed like they did that on purpose. Because over the holiday season, Thanksgiving to Christmas, people were buying these as like small gifts and stocking fillers. And YesTo let it happen, knowing that there was a problem with their sheet mask. They say that consumers were forced to suffer the consequences while the defendant reaped significant financial compensation from upsetting consumers. Sounds like dodgy practices to me. The lawsuit shows two examples, really bad examples, in a way that you're like, good for the people suing or whatever, but it looks bad. Really bad reaction from the users of the Grapefruit Unicorn sheet mask, as well as quoting some previous complaints about the product that was posted on Facebook, which YesTo ignored, including this one with the attached picture. This product completely messed up my face. After only 5 minutes of wear, I am beyond angry and have contacted your customer service via email. I will warn everyone I know about your products. This comment had the picture attached where you can see the outline of the mask. You can see it. This is getting a little bit warm, and I don't know whether it's just me making up things in my head because of everything I'm reading. It smells like citrus sick. I hate it. The lawsuit then goes on to say that basically Whitfield and all the other customers she's representing aren't idiots. They trusted the developer of these products, YesTo, to produce a product that matches what they advertise, a glow-enhancing, glow-boosting sheet mask. They read the packaging, used the product as directed, and instead of brighter skin, all they got was red skin. And of course, the lawsuit asks for compensation for everyone who was affected. Now, before we talk about how and if this was resolved, I just want to share my opinion. We've seen this before with EOS, within skincare, people having bad reactions to certain ingredients. It's normal, you expect it. Products that make people break out have a severe reaction. It happens. So why do I feel different about this product? In my unprofessional opinion, it's not a case of people just having an irritation to certain ingredients or being allergic to certain stuff. It's a case of poor product formulation. The very fact that YesTo pulled this off their shelves, they knew they fucked up. They knew something was wrong. You know, EOS were just like, sorry, have a voucher so you could buy more products. You know, their product didn't go anywhere. This had to get rebranded, taken off the shelves. You know? So yes, my main issue here is the ingredients. We have a bunch of potentially irritating ingredients in here, and that's not to say that you should avoid these at all costs. When they're formulated well, they're formulated well. We have citrus juices, exfoliating acids, particular fragrances that are known irritants, vitamin C in what, judging by the reactions, is a very poorly formulated product. But don't take my word for it. I actually spoke to friend and fellow content creator and cosmetic chemist Esther Olu, one of my favorite more educational science profiles, kind of follow over on Instagram. And we looked at this case together, and I basically said, you know, what in your professional opinion could have been the issue here? I can't tell if I'm redder than when I was. No, I think I'm okay. I'm just gonna let that settle for a bit. A bit tingly. So Esther says that in regards to the lawsuit, several things could have occurred. I suspect that the culprit was the citrus extract or a combination of the plant extracts in the formula. When it comes to plant extracts similar to essential oils, the batch-to-batch composition is not always the same, i.e. consistent. As plants, extracts, essential oils, etc. consist of hundreds to thousands of compounds, you don't essentially know what you're getting. For example, one batch may have had too high a concentration of a certain compound that caused a reaction in the consumer's skin, whereas the other batch had a lower concentration of the compound. Other issues that may have happened was a manufacturing issue in which a batch was potentially contaminated, or consumers may have unknowingly been allergic to grapefruit or citrus-based compounds. Given that the former consists of humectants, emollients, which are very commonly used in other formulas, I highly doubt these were the problem. Given that thousands of people seem to have a reaction, it begs the question if this brand did HRIPT. They would basically patch test their final formula on different patients before taking it to market. And that's the thing, I do feel, had they tested this on loads of people before putting it to market, judging by how many people reacted poorly to it, they would have seen that something wasn't right. And the packaging, as much as I don't feel there's an age on cuteness, fun packaging, pinks, holographic materials, all that kind of stuff. Stereotypically, and when it comes to marketing products for kids, this is what they use. This is an attractive product for kids. And making a product with all these potentially irritating ingredients, actives, and wrapping that in kiddie packaging is beyond irresponsible. It's just fucking stupid. It's common sense. And that's where my issue with these all-natural brands come in. They have this idea that you can pick up any of their products and they're gonna be perfectly safe. Where that's not true, we know that natural extracts, natural ingredients, are some of the most irritating ingredients out there. So there is a settlement, and it's a decent settlement, actually. According to PR Newswire, the settlement goes as follows. But quickly, I'm just gonna moisturize with Plump Plump Hyaluronic Cream from Glow Recipe. I've been using the lab sample, so this is new. I'm just going to open it now. But for brighter skin, I like to keep my skin hydrated and healthy. I just find that always gives a natural, instant, brighter look to my skin. You've got like these little refill pods as well now. So the sentiment, yes, goes as follows. Anyone who purchased or used YesTo Grapefruit Vitamin C Glow Boosting Unicorn Paper Mask, stupid name, really long stupid name, in the United States at any time can make a claim. The settlement will provide 750, the settlement, hang on, what number is that? The settlement will provide 750,000 to go towards administration costs, attorney's fees with those who submit valid claims, receiving cash based on the average retail price of the product, which is estimated to be £3 for each product, $3, sorry, for each product, for up to 6 products. So you could basically get $18 back, all without having to show proof of purchase. I mean, that sounds good, right? But this was only settled pretty recently, actually, as in April 2021. After the claim started in 2019. But they were allowing people to make this claim up to August of 2021. I mean, you should be able to walk into Boots or Walmart or Ulta and trust the products that you are buying. I like that. It looks super dewy on camera, but it's not actually that. It's not this crazy. Now, finish with my round lab sunscreen, the Birch Moisturizing Sunscreen. This is SPF 50 plus, PA 4 pluses. You know, I am glad this was settled, obviously, because I think this honestly would scar me for life. Like, no exaggeration, as someone who loves skincare and loves having that time, to have that process kind of like ruined for me because I can't trust the products that I'm picking up in a shop or that I'm buying online would honestly just, yeah, scar me. I've had reactions to products before, but never to this extent where I was in physical pain or my skin looked obviously ruined. I'm just gonna finish off with my fragrance. This is a new one I'm trying. This is the Montali Paris Intense Cafe. I think it's like an oud. It's very strong. Oh. Ooh, it's not like coffee candle smell. It's like really subtle. I like that. But it's really greasy. Obviously, my sunscreen is going to like settle down to my skin. What I also find really interesting in here in this case is to see a brand who on their website cares to claim so much for their customers, their skin and their well-being. Pretty much, in my opinion, ignore the potential irritation and danger that was put onto their consumers from one of their products in order to benefit and make a financial gain. They went months before they did anything, and to me, stuff like that immediately puts me off a brand. But let me know if you've tried YesTo, if you use and love any of their products. Don't get me wrong, I get that they're affordable, they're easy accessible, cruelty-free. Did you try the unicorn mask? I know it was really popular for like a month before all this kind of like feedback and red face post started happening. But yes, you can watch the rest of the series here and some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.